Hello guys, welcome to another video in the series of coding. Today we are going to do the problem which is called daily temperatures. So you are given an array of integer temperatures which represents the daily temperature. Return an array answer such that answer of I is the number of days you have to wait after the ith day to get a warmer temperature. Okay, let's try to see an example to understand this. Okay, so suppose these are the temperatures, right? So let us see. For example, consider this. So next day itself there is a better temperature, right? So the answer for this case is 1. Okay, because after one day you will be able to see a temperature. 74 is greater than 73, right? You will be able to see a warmer temperature. 74 is greater than 73, so on the next day it is going to be hotter than the current day. So for this the answer is going to be 1. Okay, what about for this? In this case, see, next day is not warmer, right? Because 75 is greater than 71. So you will have to go further. You can try going here. Again, in this case, 75 is greater than 69. So you will have to go further, okay? Again, in this case, 75 is greater than 72. You will have to keep going further till you find a day. In this case, we have found a day when 76 is greater than 75, right? So how many days did you have to wait? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to wait 4 days to get a warmer temperature, okay? So, in for this case, the answer is 4. So, the brute force approach is O of n square, because for each day, keep on moving forward, keep on trying to find where you will get the number, and as soon as you get the number, take the difference between the indices and the difference will give you the answer, which in this case, for example, will be 4. Okay. But this is not the best solution. So, there is a better solution, right? We'll discuss two solutions. Okay. So, first solution is the solution which will take extra space. So, we'll discuss that solution. So, that solution is, see, we have to go forward in time, right, to try to find. So what about if we had already stored 76? If somehow we already knew that there's going to be 76, okay, and we can just look up quickly and we can know that the answer for this will be this possible value, okay? So how can we do that? So we'll have to start from back, because whenever we are looking at some particular index, we'll have to look at the right side. So we'll start iterating from this side, okay? We'll start iterating from right to left, and we will use a stack structure. So I take 73. Stack is empty, right? There is no number after this. So for this case, the answer is 0. Okay. And I will say I will store 73 here. Okay. Now I come here. I come to 76, right? I come to this value 76. Now I see that the in the future I just have one value, which is 73. So I can never get a warmer day, right? I just have 73. Okay, so what I do, I will remove this 73, and because 73 is smaller than 76, okay, and now my stack becomes empty. That means there is no day in the future which is warmer than 76. So in this case also, answer is 0. Okay, and now we'll put 76 for future use. We'll come here, he'll come to 72. Now 72, when 72 sees the top of the stack, it sees 76. That means there is a warmer day, okay. But now what happens? You stored the number 76. You didn't store the index, right? So we'll have to keep looking 76. So what you can do, instead of storing the number, store the index. Okay. So if instead of 76, I had stored the index here. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If instead of 76, I had stored the value 6 here, then I know that at 6th index, I have the number 76. And now my 76 is greater than 72. That means I have found my answer, okay? So I know the index of this is 6. The current index is 5. 6 minus 5 is 1. So I can store 1 as the answer. So here I will store 1. And so 76 is there in the stack. I will not delete it, right? And I will also put 72 in the stack. Okay. Now let me go forward to the next value. Next value 69. Again, okay? So again 69. So I am not storing the number. I am actually storing the indices. Just for representation case, I have written the number. But what we are actually storing in the stack are the indices. So we'll store the index 6, we'll store the index 5. Okay. Now we have the element 69. We'll compare it with the value stored in stack at the 5th index. Okay. So 5th index, we have the value 72. So we'll see that 72, right? 72 is greater than 69. 72 is warmer than the current temperature, which is 69. So we can note the index 5. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. 1 will give us the answer. After one day, we will see a warmer value, right? So this was 6, this was 5. We will also put 4. The index number 4, we will put it in the stack, which will be 69. Let's put 69. And the answer for this case will also be 1. Okay, just after one day, you will be able to see a warmer case. Now we will see 71. Okay, so 71, Now, when you see the temperature 71, right, you will see the topmost of the stack is index 4. At index 4, you have the number 69. Now, 69 is smaller than 71. It is not warmer, right? So, in this case, you can just remove this element from the stack so that you will see the next element. Now, next element is index 5. Index 5, you have 72, right? Now, 72 is greater than 71. So, what is your answer in this case? 5. 5 minus 3 is your answer. 5 is the index that you need. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. 2 is the value that you need, and you can store 2 here. Okay, let's go forward now. Before going forward, we can also put the value 71 so that it can be used up later. So 71 is at index number 3. So basically we are storing indexes in the stack. We need not store the numbers. Just for representation, I have written the numbers. Next we have 75. So now to find out the answer for 75, we'll compare the top of the stack 3. At third position, we have 71. Now, 71 is less than 75. This is not a warmer day. So, we can just remove it from the stack. Again, we'll compare at index number 5, we have 72. 72 is also less than the current element, which is 75. Okay, so again, we can pop it. These are useless elements. Okay, these are useless elements. So, now we will see this value at the top of the stack, which is 6. So, at 6th index, right? At 6th index, I will be able to find my answer, which is 76. Now 76 is greater than 75, so I have found the answer at the 6th index. Okay, so 6 minus 2, this is 6, this is 2. 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. After 4 days, I'll be able to get the answer, so I can store 4 as the answer here. Okay, so this is 6, and let's go forward. Now we have 74, right? So now for 74, we can just before going forward, I'll also store 75 at index number 4. Now let's go forward. For 74, we'll see the top of the stack, which is at index index 2. Okay, so now we'll see the top of the stack, which is at index 2, and at index 2 we have 75. So 75 is greater than 74. We have satisfied the condition. So 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 is our answer. So we'll store 1. Okay, and before going forward, I will also push it in the stack. Now let's see the last element. Last element is 73. Top of the stack is at index 1, we have 74, right? So 74 is greater than 73. 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. 1 will give us our answer. So this will be the entire array that we can build. Okay, so using the stack based approach, very easily we can solve this problem. Okay, let's see the code for that, and then we'll discuss one more approach where we need not use this extra space. The only drawback of this is you need O of an extra space for this stack. Okay, so let us see the stack based solution. So this is stack, and answer is something that we are returning for all the elements. So this is the answer vector that you are returning finally. Okay, and we are using an additional stack, taking the last index and starting iterating from the last index. So we are starting to iterate from the reverse side. Now if stack is empty, you can simply push the current index. We are always pushing the index. Okay, so we are always pushing the index of the element. If stack is empty, for example, in the last element case, stack will always be empty. You can just push last element in the stack. If there is no element greater than that element also, stack will be empty. In that case, you can just push it, right? So you can push it, and you can push 0 in the answer because there's no element greater than the current element. Okay. Else, while the topmost element, right? So while the topmost element, the value of the topmost element is less than or equal to the temperatures of high. Okay, let's take an example. So let's say we have another element here. Let's say we have another element here. Let me call it 75 again. Okay, let's say we have 75. So what we'll do, we will see the top of the stack, right? We'll see the top of the stack, 74. So while this top of the stack, right, we are storing index. So we will go to that index, we'll find out the value of that element, right? So 74. So now 74 is less than 75. It is not a greater element. So we will keep on popping it from the stack. Okay, so we'll keep on doing this operation. That's what I'm doing. So s dot top will give me the index of the topmost element, and temperatures is the name of the array. So this will give me, this value is, for example, 74, and 74 is less than the current element, which is 75 in our case. So then, since that is less, we will pop it, and we'll keep on doing this operation till we have smaller elements at the top. Okay, because we want to reach to the next greater element. So we'll keep on doing this. After this, in this case, if stack is empty, right, that means there's no element that is greater than it. In that case, we'll do the same operation as this. Okay, we can just push the current element's index, and we can push 0. If the stack is not empty, there is some element which is greater, right? There is some element which is greater, so we can push the difference of that index and the current index, because we need to push the difference between the indexes, right? And then we can push the current index. So that's it. And finally, since we are taking it in the reverse order, we can just reverse the answer and we can return it, right? So that is a simple logic that is there. Okay, so now I will run this code and see if it's working. So it's working, right? Let's submit and see if it's getting accepted. So it will get accepted also, right? So this is fine. Now there is one more approach to solve this question, right? And that approach is also a beautiful approach. We need not use this extra space, right? So let us think about it, okay? Let us take one example and think about another approach, okay? See, consider the case. Okay, let's consider this case. Suppose you want to find answer for 75, right? So in this case, you want to find which is the next greater element of 75. Okay, so in this case, what you will do? You will keep on trying to find out the next element after 75, right? So 75 is the element that you are currently seeing. So what you will do? The next element has to be somewhere in this range, right? Next element has to be after this. So we'll start from this position, okay? We'll start checking from the just next position 3. First, I will check 71, okay? 71 is less than 75, right? 71 is less than 75. So this will not satisfy our condition, okay? Now, I need not check 69, okay? See, in the brute force approach, what we are doing, we were keeping on checking if all the elements, right? And if whichever element satisfies, that gives the answer. But in this case, we will not do the brute force approach, rather. Okay, we will come to this index, we will check at this index 71. 71 is less than 75. So, this will not be our answer. We will look at this answer. The answer will be found at least after two places. If at all there is an answer, it will be found after two places. It will not be found here. If 71 is not the answer, right, which is greater, 69 can never be the answer, because see, element that is greater than 71 is found after two places. So element that is greater than 75 will also at least be found after two places only. It cannot be found on this position. It cannot be 69, right? So that is the logic. So here, when we are going to this, we will move our pointer now. Okay, let's take properly, okay? So let's say there is an iterator that we have, that is at currently index number 3. We are checking this value 71, okay? 71 is less than 75. It is not giving us our answer. So what we'll do? We will move our iterator plus 2, okay? So we'll see the answer of this. We'll move our iterator to the fifth position. So now we'll directly jump and try to check the fifth position. Okay, now we have 72. Again, we'll check. 72 is also less than 75. This is also not giving our answer. So we will check this answer 1. We will move our element 5 plus 1, which will be 6. We will move the element at 6th position. Now we have 76. Now we will check 76. 76 is greater than 75. It is satisfying our condition. So it is going to give us our answer. Okay. So this is also one beautiful approach. In this case, we will not even need any extra space. You do not need any stack. Just keep jumping positions. You have already saved the answer. So use the already saved answer and jump the positions and reach to the final answer. Okay. Let's discuss the code for that. So let me do one thing. Let me remove this code and let us see the code for that. So we'll see the code for that. Okay, so in this case we have n is equal to temperatures dot size, and initially I'm taking the hottest element. Okay, why do I need the hottest element? See, in this approach there is one thing, right? See, if you had reached, for example you had reached this value, okay, and in this case, suppose this was not 76, this was 75 again, right? If this was 75, you will not find the answer here also, okay? So in this case, what you will do? You will keep on adding 0. You will add 0, you will reach the 6th index again. Again, you will see 0, you will keep on adding 0, you will reach the 6th index again. You will reach into an infinite loop, right? So to avoid that infinite loop, right? To be ensured that there is always an answer right side and you do not reach this infinite loop, there is one thing. If this temperature is the maximum or the hottest temperature that we are seeing currently, just store it. You need not try to even look in the right indexes, right? So that is the logic. Okay, else. So if this condition is not satisfied, that means there is definitely an answer, because if this is not the maximum element, there is some element greater than it. So then you enter into the else condition. So you just take the iterator and you keep on adding the value at the answer which we have already stored, okay, until we find that particular value. So this while loop will find the value. After it finds the value, just store the difference between the value and then return answer. So this is another beautiful solution which does not use any extra space. So that's it. I hope this works. Thank you for being patient and listening.